Hello and welcome to the Boots and Flicks YouTube channel. This upload features a very good, especially bearing in mind its age, audience recording of the Jeff Beck Group playing at the Boston Tea Party venue in Boston, Massachusetts on Thursday, the 24th of October, 1968. The concert recording will follow the usual spoken introduction. This will be a short spoken intro for a change. The Boston Tea Party venue was one of the busiest live music venues in the late 1960s. The Grateful Dead played there more than a few times. The Velvet Underground played there so often they might as well have moved in there. And actually, at some point, I think they did. The Stooges, played a scattering of dates there around 1969, but unhappily, no recordings of the Stooges live at the Boston Tea Party have ever turned up. And a little outfit from the UK called the Jeff Beck Group performed there. And what a little bunch they were. You had a very young and acne-ridden Rod Stewart on vocals and rhythm guitar, Future Faces and Rolling Stones guitarist Ron Wood on bass, the Rolling Stones house pianist Nicky Hopkins on piano, Mickey Waller on drums, and Jeff Beck, who sadly passed away recently, on lead guitar. And you really do sense the loss of Jeff Beck when listening to this recording, because his guitar playing is simply off the fucking charts, even by the standards of today, in 2023. Back in 1968, Jeff could stand alongside, and he did, the fledgling guitarists of the time, such as Eric Clapton, Jimmy Page, Pete Townsend, Ry Cooder, and yes, he deservedly stood alongside Jimi Hendrix. Such was the power of Jeff Beck's guitar playing talent. On this night in Boston, he was on stage with one of the best blue-eyed soul singers of all time, Rod Stewart, who also plays rhythm guitar on Beck's Bolero. Nicky Hopkins, who would later play on the best Rolling Stones records and tour with said band on their most celebrated tours of the 1970s. He tinkles the ivories on this Thursday evening. Ron Wood on bass, who would join up with Rod Stewart in the following years to form one of England's most beloved rock and roll bands, The Faces. And following their dissolution, he went on to join the Glimmer Twins around 74, 75. This is one hell of a lineup, listeners, and you can hear the future of late 20th century rock music on this recording. The blues power of Led Zeppelin, the sleazy grooves and piano of the Rolling Stones, the good old-fashioned lads out on the tiles atmosphere of a rowdy Faces gig, and the magnificent primal sonic scream of Jeff Beck's guitar. Like I said a few minutes ago, this will be a short spoken intro, and I'll segue into the recording itself now. This is a very good and on occasion excellent audio quality recording of the Jeff Beck Group, taped almost 55 years ago in one of the best indie underground rock music clubs of the 1960s. It's a loose, bluesy performance by an incredible and jaw-dropping collection of musicians. So let's jump back 54 years by a couple of beers at the Boston Tea Party Bar, join an audience of far-out music fans and experience the power of blues delivered to you by the Jeff Beck Group live. Jeff Beck!
Thank you.
Thank you.
for our favourite DJ, your own Wolf. He's in the mix. Come on, look here. Nicky, I'm over this one. Mother's Rice Pudding, so really get into this one. There's a gas.